Friends, we are in a most beautiful state with a beautiful Chief Minister, Sri Manohar Parikar. And Sri Jayant Sinha, one of the most knowledgeable ministers in the Government of India, Minister for Civilization, State, Sri Harikiran Vadramani, founder of the Indic Academy, and various distinguished people who have come from various parts of here and also outside, we have all joined together in this evening function. I am delighted to participate in this event and present awards to the deserving recipients from different walks of life. Initially, I was supposed to come and inaugurate this on the very first day. I have given my consent to Ram Madhav, but subsequently what happened, this World Telugu Conference has been announced on 15th, that is yesterday, where being a Telugu man and then a World Telugu Conference is being held, occupying a constitutional position. If I don't go, there will be greater disappointment. So I told them that normally the Vice President either comes for the inauguration or comes for the valedictory. I said I don't mind about protocol, I will come next day and I will give the awards. That's why I'm here. I feel sorry for the inconvenience. Friends, apart from recognizing the talent and merit of the winners, these types of awards provide inspiration to others. The very idea of giving award is not a big reward, but it's a inspiration to others to work hard and get that recognition. This is part of Indian culture. What we call it, like Indian culture or Bharatiya culture or Hindu culture, whatever it is. This is the culture that was given to by our forefathers. That is Pratibha Puraskar. Wherever there is a talent, recognize it, respect it, and felicitate it, so that the others also strive hard. That has been our culture. Friends, as a matter of fact, recognizing talent and merit has been part of our culture and also our traditions. Of course, it is needless to say that there is no dearth of talent among Indians. There is an abundance of talent, and which has to be encouraged, promoted, and duly recognized in all walks of life. I am happy that India Foundation with the Swaraj magazine has taken up this noble cause of recognizing, respecting, and then encouraging such talent. You are all aware India in ancient times controlled more than one-third of the global wealth, and about 2 centuries ago the country's GDP was 27% of the world GDP. India was known as Vishwaguru, and servants of knowledge seekers from all over the world used to come here to study at Nalanda, Takshashila, Vikramashila, Pushpagiri and Vallabhi universities. There was abundant knowledge even today among our people, ordinary people, the weaver, the fisherman, the tapper, the goldsmith, the blacksmith. In every walk of life, there are people with talent. What is required is giving them little more encouragement and respect. I would like to recall a few observations. Well-known American historian Will Durant had this to say about India. I quote, "India was the motherland of our race, and Sanskrit, the mother of European languages. She was the mother of our philosophy, mother through Arabs, of which our mathematics, mother through the Buddha, of the ideas embodied in Christianity, mother through the village community of self-government and democracy. Mother India is in many ways mother of all of us." This is what he has said about India. So Adi Kal se, Veda Kal se, jo Purana Kal se, Purvajon ne jiya aur diya, virasat mein humko diya. Wahi Bharatiyata hai. Wo jisko kuch log usko Hindutva bhi kahte hain, rehte Indianness kahte hain, isme kisi ko koi aapatti nahi hona chahiye. Karan kya hai, is beech mein kuch log, ye to hamara system ka durbhagya hai, kuch log Hindu mane usko narrow religious connotation mein dekhte. Hindu is not a narrow religious connotation. It's a larger identity of way of living of the people of this country for years together. That's why this civilization is able to survive after so many onslaughts. The Egyptian civilization, the Babylonian civilization, or the Roman civilization, or the Greece, Athens, all the great civilizations and Indian civilization. See how Indian civilization still thriving in spite of all the onslaughts. India has the history of not attacking anybody in the world with all its might of having 1/3 of the GDP of the world. India has no history of attacking any country. We can proudly say that. But every Tom, Dick and Harry came and attacked us. Ruined us, ruled us, looted us, cheated us. Not only cheated us, but also cheated some of our minds also. Even now we are not able to come out of it. Itna saal ke baad bhi, aajadi ke baad bhi hum us manasikta se bahar nahi aa pa rahe. I feel really sad about the same. Because those people through their education system, they have put in our minds that they are superior and we are inferior. And that feeling, and also has been encouraged because we started neglecting our mother languages. I always feel, friends, I feel like telling in every meeting, four things should be respected. One, mother who has given you birth. Kanna Tali, what I call in my language, mother. Second is the Janma Bhumi, the place where you are born. Third, Matru Bhasha, the language that has come from mother's womb. Be it Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Konkani, Bhojpuri, Assami, whatever language it is, even if it is Urdu, I have no problem, which has come from your mother's womb, or whatever language it is. And the last one is the motherland, the country to which you belongs to, the place where you are born. All these things should be respected. We have huge population, and we have different languages. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh, vividhata mein ekata, bharat ka visheshata. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, region, India is one. We are one nation, we are one people. That feeling is very much necessary. I'm happy India Foundation and the Swaraj magazine is promoting such thoughts. Because, as I told you, because of the onslaught of the Western civilization, the damage that is done to us. There is nothing wrong in learning other languages. The country is such that we believe in Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. We believe in Vasudhaika Kutumbam. And any change, any good thing, any good practice anywhere in the world, it's welcome. That has been our attitude in India. So there is no way that one can really comment on us in spite of some aberrations taking place or some people indulging in some idiotic thoughts or idiotic expressions somewhere. Our basic philosophy, our country, our culture. When I was talking about the culture, one person asked me, sir, tell me what is the culture. I said, culture is way of life. Religion is way of worship. You worship anybody. You worship Jesus. You worship Muhammad. You pray to any God your choice. And there is no dearth of gods in India. You have crores of them also. Gods and goddesses. Gods and goddesses also. No problem. Religion is only a way of worship, whereas culture is a way of living. How do you live? Then he asked me, sir, what is culture, sir? Please explain in simple words. Then I told Babu, ye to jeevan paddhati hai. Phir bhi unko samajh mein nahi aaya. Unhone kaha, sir, panita mat lijiye, you are known for one-liners. Please explain it in one line. Maine kaha, pura jeevan paddhati ko one line mein explain karna itna aasan nahi. It's not that much simple to explain it in one line. He said, sir, please. Then I told him, what is culture? Bharatiya culture or Hindu culture, Indianness is very simple. If you have a roti, you eat your roti, that is called as prakriti. If you have a roti, if you snatch the roti from other fellow and eat it is vikruti. And if you have one roti and the other fellow is starving, if you give a roti to the other man, that is called as samskruti, jeevana paddhati, Bharatiya jeevana paddhati. That's how we live. So friends, the American writer and humorist Mark Twain has said, India is the cradle of the human race, the birthplace of human speech, the mother of history, the grandmother of legend, and the great grandmother of tradition. Our most valuable and most instructive materials in the history of a man were treasured up in India only. This is not what Venkaiah Naidu, Vice President of India, is saying. Because there is another weakness in our system. Unless somebody from outside comes and tells you what you are, you don't recognize it. I remember during my college days, there was some Ramayana play. We all went and we enjoyed it and came, then afterwards subsequently the film also has come. So I was telling my friend, what is there, sir? Ramayana, Rama came and then he sent Sita and then finally he fought with Ravana and all, okay. I saw. He did not evince much interest. There was vacation. Then I went for vacation and came back after 1 month. Those days vacations used to be long. Now most of the time is vacation only. So there is no need for longer vacations. So then I came back, my friend was telling, Ramayana is very great. I said, suddenly, kya bhai, kya ho aapko, Rama aaya kya aapka neend mein? Nahi, recently one man from America came here and he gave a lecture about Ramayana, how beautiful it was. So that's why I quoted these two people, Mark Twain and also Durant. Iconic scientist Albert Einstein said, I quote, we owe a lot to Indians who taught us how to count, without which no worthwhile scientific discovery could have been made, unquote. History shows that India was never an aggressor, as I told you. India is a peace-loving country, and Indian people are also peace-loving. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. The reflecting the age-old cultural ethos of this country, every one of us must feel proud of having inherited such a glorious and pacifist past. This time has come now for all of us to build a new India, which shall again take its rightful place in the comity of nations. And anything, discrimination on the basis of caste, discrimination on the basis of religion, discrimination on the basis of region, discrimination on the basis of caste or sex, discrimination on the basis of your belief, this should not be allowed at all. That has not been the tradition of India. Anybody who is indulging such things, he has to be identified, and law must take its own course, and the society must also come together to tell him what you have done is wrong. But only thing, in a weakness in our system is that because of politics, you try to highlight it and then blow it out of proportion. And sometimes people try to make it heroism also. And thanks to the media, sometimes media makes it very sensational, thereby hurting the national interest also. You have to identify them. You have to isolate them. You have to take action against them without any mercy. I am very clear about it. Otherwise, this will spoil the name of the civilization. In fact, the Vedas speak of equality, universal peace, tolerance, non-violence, welfare and brotherhood. There is nobody superior or inferior. Vedas. Some people say this has been the system, sir, in India from the beginning. There is nobody who is superior or inferior according to the Vedas. Answers for many problems facing the world can be found in the Vedas, which provide us with guidance needed to achieve moral, economic, social and political development. Friends, India is set to become the fastest growing large economy again. Only the other day, the United Nations World Economic Situation Report projected India GDP to grow at 7.3% in 2018 and 7.4% in 2019. And they are saying that we will move towards 8 and then 10 in the coming years. So it's not only this report, the World Bank report, the International Monetary Fund, the Moody's rating, not Modi's rating. I'm talking about the Moody's rating. All these are clear indication that India is on the rise. India is moving forward in spite of world economic slowdown. There are great opportunities. I was minister for some time till recently. I am not part of the government now. I am not part of a party. I do not belong to Manohar Parikar's or Jayant Sinha's party now. I am out of politics. I can frankly speak, but also some limitations are there because I am the Vice President of India, holding a constitutional responsibility. It is said the outlook for India remained largely positive, underpinned by robust private consumption and public investment, as also due to the ongoing structural reforms. The Prime Minister said, I liked it. He said, reform, perform and transform. Transform the society. Transform the system. Just now, Tripathiji was telling, Avanaji was telling about the discrimination these people have faced for years together. This is the transformation that has to come. Such a person has been invited, identified, respected, recognized, and called here, and then given an award. This speaks of the transformation that is taking place in Indian society. In the coming years, the economy is expected to improve further as a result of various reforms in India. Is projected to become the third largest economy in the world by 2028. However, every reform must have a human face, and the fruits of development must reach all sections, particularly the poorest of the poor, the downtrodden, the suppressed, the depressed, oppressed people. Mahatma Gandhi, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Pandit Dindal Upadhyaya, all of them have told us that we must take care of the poorest of the poor. Jo antima pankti mein baithe unka uttan pahre karna chahiye. I am not talking to the people who are sitting in the last row here. I am talking of the people who are backward, who are neglected, who are not recognized. That's the philosophy of our leaders, great people, irrespective of political ideology they have given to us. And also fruits of development must reach all. Merely some people becoming rich and some big buildings coming from five-star hotels coming here and there is not an indication of our development. Development is there, means where there is no hunger, where there is no starvation, where there is no exploitation, where there is no discrimination, where everyone have shelter, where everyone have good education, then health, and then basic requirements. That's the real development, inclusive growth that is required for India, Antyodaya, uplifting the poorest of the poor. I'm happy the present political mood is of a all this side or that side, that's moving in the direction, both government and opposition. That's a healthy sign. One has to consistently maintain it. One has to consistently maintain it to have equitable growth and justice. That is what is required. The twin evils of corruption and black money have to be completely eliminated to ensure that progress is not pulled back by these evils. These are great evils. Black money and also corruption. We should not think in terms of politics, this party or that party, who is responsible, what is your share, what is my share. No. It is the duty of the society and it is duty of the government that we should be very clear about these things. And these two evils should be fought not only by the government, but also by the people. That's why when Pradhan Mantri gave the call for Swachh Bharat, Tanse, Manse, Dhanse, Tanse, body wise, Manse, mind also, no discrimination on the basis of birth, on the basis of religion, on the basis of caste, or on the basis of richness or poorness. There has to be a preference to the rural people, to the woman folk who constitute 50% of the people, towards the minorities, of towards the others, and all should be having a feeling that they are part of the developmental story of the country. That's a real growth. That's what we used to call as Rama Rajya. Now people feel shy to take the name of Rama also. Some people have that problem. I can't help it. I don't want to join debate with them also. Mahatma Gandhi said Rama Rajya, an ideal state. Rama Rajya is an ideal state because he was an ideal ruler. And also he would earn values. That's what is required to be done. I would also like to emphasize the need for greater focus on agriculture, because agriculture is our basic culture. Agriculture is our basic culture. We must nurture the agriculture. And I suggest the India Foundation, in future, there should be some award for people who have shown larger interest and also made good contribution to agriculture. Because even now, 52% of the people, they depend on agriculture. India is moving forward. World also is moving forward. Urbanization is taking place faster. I know that. I have my own experience. Earlier, I was rural development minister. I ended as an urban development minister. Education, employment, entertainment, enhancement of economic opportunities, and enhanced medical facilities, all these five E's are available in urban areas. So we have to focus on the rural areas. Urban-rural divide also has to be bridged. This is what Pura, Dr. Kalam has said. This is what Gandhiji also said. Grama Rajya ke bina Rama Rajya adhura hai, aisa kaha Mahatma Gandhi. He said Rama Rajya is incomplete without Grama Rajya. This has to be kept in mind. I am sure the government is focusing on that to end this rural-urban divide. And then see that the people who are living in the rural areas, they are also provided basic, and they should also be given all the latest information. And information also must go with confirmation, because information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. Information without confirmation will be only gossip. That may be useful for only headlines. But those headlines cannot be our main lines, nor they can become deadlines. They are only 1 minute headline, that's all. But that should not be the line of the country. We should think about having authentic information, which has the confirmation. So friends, I would also urge upon all of us to join the efforts of the government. The Prime Minister has set a target of making the farmers' income double by 2022. It's a challenge because agriculture is becoming unviable. People are leaving agriculture and going to other these things. Now we are all seeing that doctor want his son to be doctor. Actor want his son to be an actor, though the face is not that much good. The teacher want his son to be teacher. And the preacher also want his son to be preacher. But the agriculturist do not want his son to be an agriculturist. Why? Because of vagaries of monsoon, natural calamities, market exploitation, middleman exploitation, lack of information, all these things are affecting agriculture. The government of the day has announced many programs. I hope that those programs by center and state government and the entire society together will focus more and more on agriculture, because India is having 130 crore population. We cannot survive on imported food security. Thanks to great people like M.S. Swaminathan and also the hard-working tilling masses of India agriculturists, they have produced extra production and now we are in a position to export. We can export for the time being. But at the same time, as the growth is taking up, the growth of population also is going leaps and bounds. That has to be understood. So friends, we must go for diversification of crop cultivation, among others. Agriculture sector has to be focused, and more, there has to be value addition to the agriculture producers. I would also like to stress upon the need for women's empowerment. This time has come for a country to move forward by providing adequate representation to women in parliament and legislature. There should not be any gender discrimination. In fact, it should be remembered that women used to enjoy equal status during Vedic times. Friends, there is also need for undertaking other reforms. Some people say, no sir, ye parampara hai, bharatiya parampara hai, gruhini ko bahar jaake karna kya sir, woman ko, unko ghar mein baith ke, ghar mein hi ghar ka kaam kahan, kahan likha hai, Vedas mein likha hai kya? Is it written in Vedas that woman should confine to kitchen? Nowhere it is written. That may be system for in the families for some time. But today the situation has changed, and Indian system, and sorry to attribute it again to the Indian system by some people. No, that's not the system. Right from Vedas, or even Puranas. Purana also, there are devata, gods and goddesses. You have goddess Saraswati, minister for education. You have a goddess Durga, minister for defense. Then you have goddess Lakshmi, minister for finance. What a great example. These are all Puranas. We want to believe it or not, but there are Puranas are there, na? You have been hearing about the same. That shows the respect. And also take any Nadi in this Mandovi. Mandovi. Here in Goa. Mahanadi. There. And then Narmada, Tapati, Mahendra Tanaya. Beautiful names. Krishna, Godavari, Yamuna, Saraswati. All are named after women only. Rivers. And the country also we call it as Bharata Mata. Not Bharata Pita. That shows our ancient people, our culture always used to give respect to women. And I also feel that there is every need for elections together. Not because of this government or that government, because it became a regular activity for political parties, three-point program. Election, selection, correction. Now one round of election is over, there will be another round of election now in other states. Then after that, another state. So where is the state of mind for the politician to apply about growth, about development? There has to be simultaneous elections at all levels, from parliament to panchayat. Everything should be finished in 1 month. But for that, you need a political consensus. The entire. And then another important thing is that we must also change our mindset and should not look into the prism of community or caste or religion about terror. Terror has no religion. Terror is the enemy of the humanity. We should all understand that. And we should nip it in the bud itself. Earlier, Western countries did not understand our pain, because one of our neighbors is aiding, abetting, funding, training terrorists and trying to destabilize our economy. That's a fact. In spite of our best intentions to have friendly relations, we want friendly relations with all, including Pakistan. There's no doubt about it. But at the same time, there has to be reciprocation. We cannot allow any other country to interfere in India's internal affairs in the name of religion or in the name of something else, and try to create tensions. If there is tension on the border, there cannot be attention towards development. That has to be understood by all of us. So these are the challenges that are there. So friends, what I am suggesting is that the legislature and also the parliament, they should also focus more on constructive debates. I am the chairman of the Rajya Sabha now. Kisne kitna disturb kiya? उस पार्टी का रिकॉर्ड क्या है, इस पार्टी का रिकॉर्ड क्या है, वो सब है, मगर पार्लियामेंट का रिकॉर्ड क्या है, यही पूछेंगे लोग. सो वी हैव टू सी दैट द पार्लियामेंट फंक्शंस विदाउट मच डिसरप्शन. डिस्कस इश्यूज थ्रेडबेयर. आई रिकॉल व्हाट प्रणब मुखर्जी जी सेड. ही सेड डिस्कस डिबेट एंड डिसाइड, डू नॉट डिसरप्ट. थ्री डीज, डिस्कस डिबेट डिसाइड, बट डोंट यूज द फोर्थ डी, दैट इज डिस्टर्ब. So this is what is required. And then nothing wrong. In democracy, there will be arguments, counter-arguments, criticism, counter-criticism. Aarop pratyarop hota rehta hai. Sarkar ko gherna vipaksh ka kaam hai. It is their duty to corner the government, to confront the government, to ask the government, to get the questions. But question hour must go on, na? Then only you can ask questions. That's why I say, in parliament, you have to contribute. You can talk out. And you want to protest, you can walk out. But no breakout. That should be there. And then secondly, friends, in democracy, everyone must be tolerant to hear the other's views, irrespective of their numbers. And you must also be tolerant towards the mandate of the people also. That's also an important thing. Both are important. Both are important. The government proposes. Let the opposition oppose. Propose. Oppose, let the house dispose. Parliament should dispose it rather than having these disturbances. This is what I wish. And all political parties must ponder over these issues. And then the people's representatives should discuss the issues threadbare. The special session of the parliament on the occasion of golden jubilee of the country's independence, the MPs had solemnly affirmed their commitment to maintaining the inviolability of the question hour, refraining from transgressing into the official area of the house, or from shouting of slogans, and invariably desisting from any efforts at an interruption with the address of the president. This is not my prescription. This is what has been decided on the eve of the 50th year of independence by the entire parliament together. All of them has taken a solemn pledge. I only appeal to them, please remember this. We are a mature democracy. And we call as one of ourselves as the finest parliamentary system in the world. And the world is looking towards us. And children in the school, in the college, in the society, they look to parliament for guidance. So the parliamentarians should be an outstanding examples of decency, decorum and discipline. And then friends, I also feel that the conduct of a person is very important. And then the entire system should go by merit. Merit, I am not talking of the reservation type of thing. I am talking about recognizing the merit. We have recognized some merit people today. Recognizing the merit and the selection or election should be on the basis of 4 C's: character, caliber, capacity and conduct. But unfortunately, in between, sometimes we move from 4 C's to 3 C's. What are the 3 C's? 3 C. One is caste, second is community, third is cash. In democracy, In democracy, character, caliber, capacity and conduct are important. Discipline, dynamism, dedication and devotion is important. But not the caste and community and cash. Unfortunately, this trend also here and there. When I was talking here and there, he said, sir, everywhere. I said, no, that situation has not yet come. Don't worry on that count, but we have to be careful. The society should really look at the performance of the individuals or the parties and whatever they have promised, what they have done. Friends, today I am happy that Dr. B.R. Shenoy Award on Economics, Dr. Niranjan Rajyadakshaji, who is the executive editor of the Mint magazine, he has been chosen for this award. I compliment him and congratulate him on behalf of all of us who have joined here. Then, Ustad Bismillah Khan Award for Culture, Srivennara Sitarama Shastri, a beautiful poet, writer. I know him since his younger days. And now he's a name in the Telugu cinema field. And I'm happy that he has been chosen for this award of Ustad Bismillah Khan Award for Culture. And then Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Award for Politics. Hemant Biswas Sharma, the minister from Assam, he has been identified for the same. Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee was such a great personality and he resigned on differences with the Prime Minister, Pandit Nehru. And he used to face Pandit Nehru. Pandit Nehru was a great freedom fighter, parliamentarian, and a great towering personality. To stand in front of Pandit Nehru was not an ordinary thing those days, but he stood. And he proved to be best parliamentarian also. So that award of Dr. S.P. Mukherjee Award is given to Sri Hemant Biswas Sharma. I compliment him and congratulate him. And Sri Narayana Guru Award for Social Work, Lakshmi Narayana Tripathi. Lakshmi Narayana Tripathi ji is a transgender rights activist, Hindi film actor and Bharatanatyam dancer in Maharashtra. So it was rightly said and then done that recognition is given and this is a great moment for all the people across the country, that once again we are back to our basic culture, basic roots. So I compliment Lakshmi Narayana Tripathi for this award of Narayana Guru. Narayana Guru is such a social reformer. Unfortunately, in our country, there is another weakness. Some of these great heroes, they are localized. Sometimes they are communitized also. He belongs to this community. That some people talk even about Mahatma Gandhi also. They belong to the entire country. They belong, do not belong to one party or one caste, one religion. This Narayana Guru in those earlier days, such a great social reformer. But many people may not be knowing. Recently I told NDMC, New Delhi Municipal Corporation, by name one of the roads as Narayana Guru. Guru is always very important, you know that. Along with the mother tongue, and motherland and the Janma Bhumi, another important thing is the Guru. The Guru who teaches with all the transformation, with the advanced technology and also this IT, all these things are there, there's no doubt about it. Now anything you ask, then Google. Google is definitely useful, but Google can never replace Guru. Remember that, one should remember that. It's good that they have instituted an award in the name of Sri Narayana Guru, a great social reformer and given to a rightful person. Today in this meeting, friends, I feel it's an honor that I have been asked to come over here. Sri Ram Madhav and also Saurya Dawal and also our Vardamani Ravi, these people and also Jayant and also I'm told Prabhu, Suresh Prabhu and also a lot of people are all supporting this great organization. It's very, you need such organizations, thoughtful, useful, purposeful, but they are only handful. That's the problem. We need such organizations across the country. We need to encourage such organizations so that the society gets proper guidance. Society gets proper guidance. The intelligentsia of the country should focus on nationalism, should focus on universal well-being. That should be, and it should not be construed in a narrow meaning of nationalism or in identity of in the name of one particular religion or region. It should be for the, as I told you, sir, we believe in Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. Such wonderful thoughts are there. And this great society, this civilization is willing to take anything good from anywhere. And it has the capacity and it has digested, it's assimilated also. All those things that have come from other sites. So such organizations are very useful. I compliment them for taking up this good work. And I also congratulate all these award winners today. And also, I also would like to really thank all the people who have joined for this important meeting. Namaskar, Jai Hind.